Excel Podcast, sponsored by MrExcel. Learn Excel from MrExcel Podcast, episode 1621, Excel 2013 Charting. All right, well, yesterday I talked about the new books I wrote for Excel 2013. Charts and Graphs is one of those, and the items that are really going to make a difference in your life. So today I'm going to cover several of them about charting. The first thing that we have under charting is the new concept of recommended charts. Which chart type should you use? Well, they're going to suggest based on the data, and this is good. This is a time series. It has 12 points. Always say with 12 points, you can do a line or column. They've added an area chart in. Okay, I wouldn't have thought of that, but great. So we'll choose one of these, click OK. All right, now check this out. We used to have design, layout, and format. Layout is completely gone, replaced with a plus icon, but the icon that I love is the paintbrush. In the paintbrush, they have chart styles that actually look good as compared to the old quick layout, which was completely pointless. All right, and we'll take a look at some of these later, but there is really interesting looking charts, and they didn't do anything new. All of these were available with the old tools. You just would have had a thought of the ways to combine them. You're like, yeah, that one, that's a great way to get those data labels up there, and so on. So I really like the paintbrush icon. The other thing that's interesting is here we have a data set that's hard to chart. Two lines of numbers in thousands and one gross profit percent. Of course, this requires a combo chart, which is normally hard to do. Well, first off, the recommended chart, number one, gets it right away. Oh, hey, we're going to do columns for the revenue and profit. We're going to do a line for gross profit. So they kind of steal my thunder because I really wanted to show you what happens when I click on all charts and go to combo and do, well, it'll choose custom. This new interface is great. I get to choose which chart type to use for each series, which one to put on the secondary axis. So I have absolute control here. This is a really, really good interface to create that chart title. All right, next up, here's a data set that clearly cannot be charted. 500 rows of detailed data. Let's throw this at the recommended charts and see what happens. All right, anytime that the thumbnail has this icon, they're going to summarize things. So, sum of revenue by region, sum of profit by product, sum of revenue by product, and so on. They are looking, all right, so it's a secret, right? They're using heuristics to figure out which charts to use. They're looking for columns that have very few unique items. So in this case, I have three regions and three products, so they're using that over and over and over. Customers with 26 unique customers never shows up, but that's okay. If I really wanted to report of revenue by customer, click OK. See, they actually created a pivot table for me. I could just unchoose region, choose customer, and I now have that report. Very nice. I don't need to summarize it. They're going to summarize it for me. Kind of impressive. The other one is, here's a data set that is not suitable for charting because of the subtotals. All right, so we have January, February, March, and then here's a total of those three months. So that's going to look horrible. I would normally create a second data set that has those quarters taken out, has the total taken out, and try and chart that. Let's just create a chart, insert, recommended charts. All right, yeah, they do the same thing here. That looks great. Now, the funnel icon is really cool. I can, using the funnel icon, say, look, I don't want to show cost of goods sold. We're going to uncheck that. Also, I don't want to show Q1. I don't want to show Q2. I don't want to show Q3. I don't want to show Q4 or the total. And watch, are you seeing the chart? The chart kind of highlights or animates as I hover over each one of these. Get the total out of there. Apply. All right, and now from this data set that has subtotals added in, I've created a report with just the monthly data without the cost of goods sold data, and that's from the funnel icon in Excel 2013. Now, Excel 2013 doesn't come out till Q1, but you can try it right now for free. Go to tinyurl.com/XL13preview. We'll take a look at where to go once you get there. scroll down to the bottom, click the Excel icon, Office 365 Home Premium, and then try it. Choose your country, register if you're not signed into Microsoft.com, and it'll let you download it to 5 PCs. You'll be able to try it out for the next month or so. Hurry up, this is December 2012. It's here now. I'm sure once the product hits the stores, the preview will be gone. So take some time here over the holidays and give it a try. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another Netcast.